Just because the Mac version of VoicePrint does look so different from the PC, I'm going to take you through a little quick orientation here. First off, we need to find where we stored the application. So mine is right here. I'm going to open it, and right away I get this little floating window. So now this floating window by itself, because it's matching the Mac kind of layout, doesn't have any menu bar at the top. The menu bar is over here. So if I need any of my info, like to set my preferences, I can do that from that spot there. Or if I need to open a voice model, I can do it all from here. So let's say I'm getting ready for the CMT test. There's all of that information. Then I can check my figures. Okay. Now I can record by clicking this button here. And right away we will see the spectrogram being generated. We see my waveform up here in the signal. We're good to go. I can now save that if I wish, or I can just close it. It'll ask me if I want to save. I'm not going to save this one. Now if we're creating an exam, we can do that here. It'll ask me to save it. Save it right to the desktop. And then to archive each one of these figures, I'm just going to click it, open my first recording here. There we go, looks good. Now I can go to save and close it. And you'll notice here it's checked off. There's my first task complete as we go through. Let's say that's the only one I'm going to record for right now. So I will close it. So every time you close a window, you get back to your desktop, it looks blank. But I can tell VoicePrint is still open because this is still going up here. That menu bar is still there. If you need to access the help menu, it's right in here. And this is where you'll find any tips on how to set up your microphone, record sound, different features like our pitch tracker. And the big one here I'll point you to is what's different on a Mac. This just takes you through some more, another breakdown of what's different and where you can find this all using the menu here. Okay, so I hope that helps. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me anytime.